So it's actually quite hard to keep up doing these shows of Meet the Muslim Family. So I don't really want to give up. So every now and then I will do a clip, an unedited 5 minutes. That's what it's all about. But yeah, I just got a few minutes here, so I thought, okay, let's do it. Let me tell you what's happening in our lives at the moment. So we've recently moved to Jordan, and just moved into this house like a month ago or something. I don't know. It felt like a month ago, not that long ago. I think it's actually been 3 months. Yeah, it's been 3 months. But then we have to move again because, the reason we're moving is because there's some crazy kids around here who don't understand English-speaking people, and they throw stones at us and do stupid stuff like that. And we could tell the kids off whenever, but they could gang together, and they kind of have sometimes. And we don't want things to escalate, so that's why we're moving. Kind of, I think that's just a catalyst to make us, or that's not a catalyst, whatever the word is, to make us move to a better place. Actually, a place that has more outdoor space, but has next to none indoor space. Instead of, we've got 4 bedrooms here, and we're gonna move to a place with just 1 bedroom. All of me, my wife, and 3 kids are gonna move into 1 bedroom. So that's the story of what's happening at the moment. But part of the point of these shows is to talk about how to not panic and realize there's a plan to everything, and that's not just living in an illusion by thinking there's a plan to everything. By when you let go of your ego and stuff like that, good stuff happens, but really awkward and sometimes very uncomfortable ways. So, and we've seen, me and my wife have seen that so many times in our lives, that so many amazing things happen, but through awkward ways. So part of the point of this program is to show how you can deal with life, and that's how Muslims generally deal with life. They know there's something else going on, and they see it. It's like the Matrix. I'm sure you know the Matrix, right? It's kind of becoming aware of what's really happening. So yeah. The other thing I kind of wanted to talk about, I kind of that inspired me to just make this program, is kind of food again. Keep talking about food. I do want to take you outside, and hopefully, but I don't know when I'm going to take my computer that records these videos out. Yeah, so hey, maybe even today I'll just go around. Are we going out today? You'll see outside, don't worry. More of outside. But what inspired me today was a bit of food. And some Islamic principles about food, and the Islamic principle about food actually is to keep it simple, and which is very relevant today actually. Yeah, I was going to show you this. This is my breakfast, part of my breakfast anyway. It's not showing up very clearly, is it? Always have a problem showing stuff on the camera because everything's in reverse, so I move it this way and it does the opposite. Anyway, and I don't have a mirror effect anyway, so you can't see it, but it's cream. Oh, and I made a mess. See, I was looking at the screen. Okay, so anyway, the Islamic principle is keep food simple. And why is that so important today? Because we're getting really obsessed with food programs as if it's going to change our lives and all that kind of stuff. And that there's lots of different angles to this, okay? So we need obsessions to distract ourselves from the reality that the realities of our lives, that things are not going so well and whatever. So these food programs are encouraging us to get obsessed with something. Oh, food. Oh, that's amazing. Let's be really artistic with our food and get this crazy about it. But if you look at like Gordon Ramsay, when he talks about making good food, he actually talks about keeping it simple. And yeah, keeping it simple and tasting the food itself, the tastes of the actual original products, you see. So going back to simplicity, because we're realizing that getting too crazy about our food is actually stupid, and it's counterproductive. You stop tasting the food itself. So anyway, and also our brains are way do things handle pleasure in a way that he kind of gets used to it. And that's another Islamic principle that I'm not going to go too much into, but just chasing simple pleasure doesn't change your life. So anyway, I'm eating cream with a bit of sugar, cream made directly from just taking the top off from some sheep's milk or whatever, and it's actually thick cream and a bit of sugar, and dumping this bit of bread in the sugar. You don't see the sugar, well, you don't really need to, you know what sugar looks like. Anyway, so that's it really. And that's my daughter watching TV. Whatever. Thank you for watching.